Hello, hello, and welcome to the show. SykoYoda here with another LEGO review, and today we are doing one of the biggest sets I have ever seen, and I do believe it is the largest set that I have ever personally purchased. This one is called The Simpsons House. To say that this is big is not doing it justice. This box is abso-freaking-lutely huge. It's so big I could not put it in the background when I was creating the actual set on camera. I could not figure out how to get everything into the picture at the same time. You'll also notice very quickly that I am zoomed out more so than I usually am for these reviews. That just gives you an idea of how big this is. 2,523 pieces. We'll bump that up to over probably 205,040 pieces, because there's some extras they've thrown in for you, as they usually do, just in case something is missing in the bag or something else popped into the bag that wasn't supposed to be there. Let's go ahead and take a look at what you get in this huge box. Set number 71006 says ages 12 and up, and although there is some complication in building this, I don't think that it necessarily warrants a 12 and up rating. I would say probably an 8 and up. Now, the kicker on that is this did take me 7 hours to build. And as you can see with the amount of bags that are in front of this camera right now, there is a lot here. It is going to take some time. But if you have a kid that is a patient and you have someone who really, really likes The Simpsons at a younger age, although I do think it's a little bit of an adult-themed show, this may still be appropriate for you. This may still work for you. If your child is 8, 9, 10 years old and they have the patience to put this together, it's going to take a few days. It might take a week, but you will finish it. It is not overly complicated. It is a well thought out, well built set with 3 huge booklets. At a price of $109.99, I was a little bit on the fence whether or not I wanted to pick it up. This was something that was requested by one of you guys for me to review, and I had already been eyeballing it, but the price was like, ugh. Knowing that the colors that were in here wasn't going to work for me as far as what I needed in the set, or at least I thought, I didn't really want to put down the $200, but I didn't understand the actual size of this thing. It just didn't click with me. When you see a Lego house, typically you're thinking a smaller scale than what you got here. This thing is so big, it is larger than most of the city pieces that they have available for purchase. I mentioned colors, and that brings us into the builder's pick. When I first looked at this, I thought there wasn't really any reason to pick this up. I was not needing that sand color, or light tan as they call it, I believe. The brown is always nice because brown is something that is a little bit more difficult to get your hands on. But I didn't understand how many smooth tiles there are in this thing. Smooth tiles galore. There's smooth tiles in green, smooth tiles in this really cool yellow, different colors of blue. There's quite a bit of pink in the car, but what really stuck out as a builder's pick was this light blue that was in here. Now, this isn't something that is new. This light blue has been around in many of sets, but this one has so much of this. What you're seeing on the video right now is only half, maybe even less than half, of what actually comes in the set. I tried to get out as much as I could without popping open all of the bags to make it easier when I was putting the whole thing together. Very, very important set if you want to get smooth tiles, specifically in the green, and I think most importantly in this light blue. Moving on to the collector's pick. The collector's pick in this one has to be the whole set, but if you really want to break it down, the car's kind of cool, although you may already have the pieces to create that car. And there are a lot of sticker implements in this one that you definitely don't have unless you purchase this set. There's posters and whatnot that are in the different rooms, but the action figures themselves, the minifigs of the Simpson characters, including even Mr. Flanders from next door, you have to pick these up. Now, there is a catch to that, because you can purchase these minifigs in a minifig set package. And there's different ways you can look to see which one you're picking up before you even purchase it via the barcodes and whatnot. So you can collect all of the minifigs, I believe even the Simpsons family, from that. You don't necessarily have to purchase this. That being said, I still think this is an amazing, amazing set. It is huge. It is wonderful. The detail in it is outstanding. There's so much detail involved in all throughout this thing. I literally cannot put it all on camera for you guys. So what do I think about this set? As a wrap-up, I gotta say, knowing the Simpsons in my home since I was in grade school, it is something that I think is a must-have. Is it a must-have only because I'm a Simpsons fan? No, this is a must-have set for many reasons. But if you are a Simpsons fan and you miss out on this one, you're going to be kicking yourself. Let's go ahead and take one last look at the final product. This also does not include everything that's in the set. I have been getting rushed on this one, as you know, and I apologize for it coming out later than it usually does. But wham, there it is, man. As usual, folks, thanks for watching. If you have any comments, requests, or suggestions, feel free to leave them down below. Don't forget that like and subscribe if you enjoy my videos, and I will see you next time.